CBS presents this program in color.
Get ready to match the stars. Edward Asner, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson, and Patty Doyle as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rivers.
Lovely people over here. Hello, lovely people.
Hi, Bruno.
Lovely person.
Ask me what time it is.
What time is it?
Oh, I'll have to check. Wait a minute now.
Oh.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Oh, a Christmas present.
No.
You have a lovely head, Gene.
Oh, there it is. It's
Mickey's one hand is on the two.
11 minutes after two.
Who gave you the watch?
Well, the watch is from my father, and this beautiful little bauble here. It's a beautiful old English antique that he gave me two Christmases ago.
What's he showing?
I want it back.
Oh, no, you don't. It's 11 after 2, in case you're interested. Let's say hello to our current champ, George Frederick. George has won a bundle of money. He's got $15,900. He's won more games than anyone who's ever been on this program. He's won 11 games. And we're going to start with the audience match. Are you ready for it again?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right, now, don't move now. We'll give you a chance to catch your breath while we do a little business with America. Then we'll see if he wins more money. Hurry back. Here we go with old George for the 11th time he's up here. George, you got $15,900. We're going to see how much more money you can win now. Let's begin. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank Bears, B-E-A-R-S, Blank Bears. Now, $500 if you match the answer that audience gave most frequently. $250 for their second most popular answer, and $100 for the third answer on that list. Now, whom do you call on?
Charles.
Charles who?
Charles Nelson Reilly.
That's it. Speak up. Charles Nelson
Reilly. Well, one name for one of the Bears. Charles Nelson and Reilly, three Bears.
Three Bears.
Aww. Try to keep it down to a rally, please.
Brett.
Well, you know, I'm a very big sports fan. That wonderful baseball team, the Chicago Bears.
The Chicago Bears. Terrific. Baseball team, of course. Papa Bear will be very, Hallis will be very unhappy with you. What do you say?
And Richard.
Richard.
Oh, the Milwaukee Bears. No.
Milwaukee Bears.
Grizzly Bears.
Grizzly Bears.
Yes.
So you got Grizzly Bears, Chicago Bears, and the three Bears. Which one do you want, if any? Want one of your own?
I'll say Grizzly Bears.
What?
Grizzly Bears.
George.
Why do you say Grizzly Bears?
Well, I didn't say what Richard said last time. He said the $500.
But you asked
response,
me first the last time.
But you know the thing. The third position is a little tougher to come up
don't
with.
Don't argue
the most
with him. He's making history on this show. He has his own cool way.
Okay. Won't
he's
we
fine.
All be chagrined when Grizzly Bears turns out to be the winner up there on top? Let's find out right now. We're looking for Grizzly Bear. May we see the $100 response? Bad News Bears. That was a movie with Walter Matthau, right? Now let's see the $250 number. Chicago Bears, there's Brett's answer. All right. I tell you, if it comes up Grizzly guy, I don't believe
George.
This. You don't think it's going to happen? What do you say, Audie? Teddy Bears. Oh.
Three.
All right. May we
three
see
bears.
It, please?
Three Bears.
Three Bears. All right. Well, listen, you picked up an additional $100 for winning the game. You're up to $15,900. You're going to meet another player now. Let's welcome Gayla Lisitra. Hello there. Okay. Hello, Gayla.
Hi.
Gayla Lisitra. That's a very pretty name. What is that?
Thank you. It's Italian.
It's Italian. Lisitra. Bella ragazza questa, eh? What do you say?
Okay. It's bella.
Gayla, where are you from?
I live in Seattle, Washington.
Yep.
and I have two beautiful children. I'm very happily married.
Good. Uh-huh. What brings you to Los Angeles?
I'm drying out. It's very cold and wet up in Seattle, and I'm visiting my family for Christmas.
Oh, that's nice. You frightened me for a minute when you said you're drying out. I thought you had the same
never
problem.
Never frightened you when I say it.
Okay, here we go, Gayla. It's up to you for a choice here.
A.
A. Gayla. Gayla. Ready? Here it is. Santa Claus said, ho, 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 he, ho, 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 ho. You all know I have a list of who's naughty and who's nice? Ho, 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 ho. Well, my nice list I made up myself, but I got my list of who's naughty from blank. I got my list, Santa said, I got my list of who's naughty from blank.
Next
makes
sweet
a
question.
Nice list himself. Naughty list he gets from blank.
Oh, I know the answer to that one,
Jack. You've taken your shoes off.
Oh, nothing is sacred.
Are you uncomfortable?
No, you know, there's you can take the girl out of the South, but not
would
the
you
South
like to see something in a sneaker? I mean, we have this model also in black suede and in tan alligator. All right, let's go, Charles. He's writing, Gail. Gayla. Santa Claus says, ho, 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 ho. You all know I have a list of who's naughty and who's nice. Well, my nice list I made up myself. But I got my list of who's naughty from...
Rona Barrett.
Oh, very good answer. Little Italian lady, very smart. Come up with nice answer. Rona Barrett, she said. Gossip type lady. What do you say?
Well, I was more or less down that same alley. Ho, ho, ho.
Ho.
And he gets his naughty list from the Inquirer.
The Inquirer. The gossip newspaper. Okay, where?
No? I have the definitive answer for
I'll
this
bet you
question.
Do.
And I believe that everyone will agree. Richard Dawson's address book.
What do you say to that?
I wish it were true.
It's true enough, all right. I do not answer Santa Claus questions. Oh, that's because this recent past...
Say why it's because.
Just tell.
A year ago, we let him play Santa Claus.
Gene.
Every year for 2 years. And he dressed up in a Santa Claus thing. You know,
yes.
It was a pretend thing. And he was a good... And he did all the questions as Santa Claus
it
would
It was
answer.
Adorable.
It was adorable. You were wonderful.
I said the Wicked Witch of the North.
The Wicked... But I got one who's done it from the Wicked Witch of the North.
Oh,
that's a good answer.
More.
That's not bad at all. Hello, Marianne.
Hello.
The Shoeless Wonder. That was Joe Jackson, a famous baseball player. The Shoeless Wonder. The Shoeless Wonder.
Yes.
What do you say?
You've heard the expression, the devil made me do it.
The devil. That's good.
Now, nothing,
that's
no boo, no applause.
You got another bunch from... Yeah. What do you say to this? I got my
Rona
list.
Rona is an excellent answer. Yeah. I do not have that.
You don't have Rona Barrett.
You made up the list there of the nice people.
I have my nice list I made myself, but I got my list of who's naughty from...
The FBI.
The FBI. What do they know? Hello, neat lady.
Yellow. I said he got the naughty list from the former H.R. Haldeman.
I like that one. So, Gayla, that's the way it goes. You lose some, and you lose some. Now, George, you'll be up in a moment or so, but right now we've got this for you, and then come back. Ready, George?
Ready.
Here it is. Another game. George Jessel said...
What?
Oh, God help us.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself. Speaking out of turn that way.
George, just to say, yesterday I presided over a funeral, and it was terrible. In the middle of my eulogy, the guy in the coffin blanked. That's a George Jesselson. Yesterday I presided over a funeral, and it was terrible. In the middle of my eulogy, the guy in the coffin blanked. And I'm never to see and I'm and I my mother's eyes. My it hurts. Okay. Let's go, Ed. Ed, I'm gonna cancel your new series. Guy like you's got your own show? Couldn't even write one word already? Okay, here we go. Now, George Frederick. George Jessel said, yesterday, I presided over a funeral and it was terrible. In the middle of my eulogy, the guy in the coffin blanked.
He booed.
He booed.
All right. Then.
He booed. What'd you say, Ed, finally?
Well... Boo!
Oh.
I should. Yeah. But anyway, I'm in the same vein as George. George... Frederick.
Some negative
the
expression?
The guy, the corpse, delicious, walked.
Good. One possibility. He was so bored, he got up and walked. What do you say?
I said he was so bored, he got up and he nodded off.
He nodded off. He'd already been nodded. Charles?
Joining the answers of distinguished players throughout the country. Yawn!
Yawn is a good one. Now, yawn is what I would have said if
yeah,
I had
that's
been
you, is that what makes it good? Is that what makes it good?
Yes.
Who made you the job?
Yeah. All right, Marianne, what do you say? Looking for the answer, booed.
You would have said yawn.
I would have said yawn.
Well, I thought the eulogy was so boring...
That?
He snored.
Snored is good. These are all good.
Right in the middle of my eulogy, he booed.
Now, let's see your answer.
He said he fell asleep.
He fell asleep. He was faking it. Well, you got one out of that.
Boy,
you're really leading a charmed life here. Okay, round two coming up. Gayla.
A.
A. She thought it over and wants A. Let's see what it says here. Ralph said.
Oh, dear.
My new alligator shoes require a lot of attention. Twice a day, I have to blank them. My new alligator shoes require a lot of attention. Twice a day, I have to blank them.
Is that the second round question?
That is the second round question.
So there has to be a regular
yes.
answer.
Oh, there's one marvelous answer.
Twice. Alligators. Let me, I look at, sometimes I'm better.
I'll never
show you. Ralph said my new alligator.
Oh, yes.
No, you won't. No, come on. No, come on. Not on your life. You give me the bauble hanging from your gut.
He's not going to show his answer. All right, you ready? Twice a day I have to blank them. Okay. All right, Gayla, did you think about it? I'll read it to you one more time. Ralph said, my new alligator shoes require a lot of attention. Twice a day, I have to blank them.
Bite.
What?
Bite.
Bite them. You have seen this program.
Bite?
I mean, this is not The Price is Right, you understand. Twice a day, I have to bite them, she says. I don't understand that answer.
Well, that's pressure. It's all due to pressure.
It's pressure.
You know? Yeah.
She's nervous.
Now, he bought some undead alligator shoes, so he had to feed them.
Feed them is a good answer. Feed them. The definitive answer has already been given, but do your best.
You're
full
something.
Of static electricity.
No, I sat in some candle wax with my elbow.
Really?
What a party that was, huh?
Wow.
Because I was like this.
I see.
I also have a definitive answer. I said water and feed.
Well, that's good. Okay. Light is the answer she's looking for.
Without sticking to a thing, just feed.
Feed, yes. Light is what she wants. You got some good answers so far, Marianne? Twice a day I have to.
I hate to be repetitive, but I said feed.
Feed is good. Gayla?
I could talk to the animals. I'd say feed.
Feed is good. Right.
The tree is a feed.
All right. Well, there it is. That means George wins the game. Come on down, George. There you go. What is that? 12 times. Gayla, what can I say? We've got some gifts for you. It was a pleasure to meet you, my dear.
Thank you.
Many thanks for being with us in Match Game 77, Gayla LaCitra. While we're spinning her off, we're going to spin these messages just for you. Your old friend, George Fredericks. George Fredericks been up here 12 times. This is his 12th game. He's got $16,000 even. Here we go, George. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank on. O-N. Now, remember, you get $500 if you match your most popular answer, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third. Call them out, George.
Richard.
Ride on!
Ride on! Charles. Chuck.
Oh, what the chick said when I was out with her about two nights ago at went to the Sportsman's Lodge. She said I was a I'll try to get it right. I was a turn on.
I don't know about her, but you turned me on. I'll tell you that. I reckon you can do it either.
And Brett.
Brett. What she really said. Go on.
Go on. Go on. Turn on and right on. Those are the three. You can choose one of those or one of your own.
I think I'll go with right on.
Right on. Okay. We are looking for right on. May we slide the $100 number. Put on. Put on. That's not a bad one, is it? Put on. Good one. Let's see if right on is under the $250 number. Turn on. That's Chuck's answer. Last chance for right on. Here we go.
Right on.
As you well know by this time, George, you're going to play for ten times the $500 or $5,000. And you have to match one celebrity exactly.
I'll try again with Richard.
Okay,
it's
here we go.
Last chance, Richard.
The team, they've done it before. Let's see if they can do it again. Worth $5,000? Press blank. That's P-R-E-S-S. Blank. Now, George, what answer do you want to give us? Would you think we'll match his in this instance? Press.
Press conference.
Press conference. How would you say? Well, now, you know, I thought of that, too. Because of that previous business there, right on and all that, the first thing came to my head was press on. So I couldn't think of anything else. Let's see what Richard says. He says press conference.
I said press room.
Press room. That was a tough one.
Press man.
They were all good. Press on, press conference, press room. Okay, press man. So you got $16,500 all together. You're going to meet another player. Here comes Phyllis Lear.
Thank you.
Now, Phyllis, we want to find out a little bit about you before we begin here.
Okay, I'm from Van Nuys, California, and I have two teenagers and a Springer Spaniel dog, and I'm a secretary.
Well, aren't you cute? Doesn't she look too young to
She's a Marianne Mobley look-alike.
Yes, she does indeed.
Well, thank you very much for that.
Phyllis, we got to stop and do a little business with America, and then we'll get back to you and you. Watch this now. Here we go. Listen, we don't have time to ask you a question. I mean, in connection with the game. But we will next time we get together. Okay?
Okay.
All right. And is there anything anyone has to say before we leave here? We got a few seconds here. You have something to say? No.
No, thank you.
Haven't we got to watch the circus show tonight on CBS?
Yes,
is this tonight
Charlie,
the night?
Yes,
the and then also in February, Charlie's Angels.
Okay.
I'm working with those three beautiful
Angels.
Girls.
Oh, terrific. Wow. I wish
My
I
friend
could wear
David it. Doyle is on Charlie's Angels.
Yes,
splendid.
A nice man.
Listen, uh-huh. Join us next time for Match Game 77. I'm Gene Rayburn. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 77, a Mark Lips and Bill Todman production.
I want both of you girls to know that I really love your mom. I think we make a great family.
In a world where money can buy anything.
He's 10 years younger than you, is that good?
Ann Scripps has just found herself the man of her dreams.
Dad.
He's young.
Why can't she marry someone her own age? Somebody who can take care of her, not the other way around.
He's sexy.
You can sleep with them all you want, Mom. But it doesn't need to be serious.
He's ambitious.
Mom, he's stealing you blind. He's got copies of your bank statements, your trust account. You've got to get him out of your house.
And he'll make her life a living hell.
Oh, Scott, he just went nuts.
Open up! You think you're calling the shots?
This guy is dangerous. You have to do something.
I'm going to report an attempted murder.
If you feel that you are in danger, either you or your child, then he is threatening your life.
I'm going to drive you out of your mind.
Based on the true story.
You're not thinking!
The story that shocked the nation.
You don't call the shots, I call the shots!
Roxanne Hart. James Wilder.
Something has to be done. The threats are over.
Our mother's murder.